Come on, come on. Come on.
I don't care what kind you are. It's all fattening. You know, people tend to believe that just because they've been to church a couple of times a Sunday, that they are now holier than God.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Uh-huh. So what that you can quote a few scriptures, baby, but if your life is jacked up,
ooh,
you are nothing. As a matter of fact, you stay in the outside of God.
Yeah, yeah. Say that. Say that. Say
it's
that.
Church folk, let's talk about, we've been talking about character starting this month. We've been talking about character. Your character simply is the way you are when you are behind closed doors and no one can see you, and just the way you are is your character. But if your character at home, if you are different at home than when you are at church, your character is out of line.
Yeah, yeah, come on, talk about it. Talk about it.
You're too high level, bitch. You'll come down a little bit. I will.
Come on.
See, if you are a dirty, messed up tramp at home, don't try to come to church thinking you all that.
Come on, come on. You walking heavy.
On Sunday, somebody said, keep it real.
Go ahead.
Keep it real. Can I just see? Everybody in the Shepherd's Tavern, they know me already. So, there you didn't get
it.
You, we.
Yeah, go ahead,
Bishop. That's real talk.
Go, Bishop.
But if you are different at home,
come on.
I can't stand to see somebody. You know how you see them on Fridays and Saturdays and nevertheless on how about during the week at work? You see them cussing and then they see you because they know you feel with the Holy Spirit and you've been bought with a price, and so they see you and then it's, oh, I'm so sorry.
Come on, talk about it.
But one thing that I have found out in my ecclesiastical career is that church folk have the worst mouth in the world. See, you get quiet when I'm stepping on your toes.
Ooh,
I don't have no shoes, so it shouldn't hurt that
go
bad.
Ahead, go ahead.
But church folk are the most cussing folk in the world.
Go ahead.
If you don't believe it, go look at Facebook.com. All my sons and daughters who have Facebook, I'm checking you out.
Go ahead.
Check me out.
There's
something wrong because, see, listen, folks, let me drop this in your spirit, and I'm leaving it alone. Facebook is not for you to exercise your preaching gift.
Come on.
If you don't go to church, Facebook ain't going to help you.
Go ahead.
I don't want to go too long.
Go ahead.
See, but it's funny how church folk, you can come to church Sunday after Sunday and pretend like you're holier than thou, but on Monday mornings you drop your religion.
Come on. They pick it up on Sunday, Bishop.
Yeah. Somebody say real tall.
Yeah, go ahead.
See, when your character, one thing about God is that God said you cannot be lukewarm either.
What?
You're going to be hot,
yeah,
or you're going to be cold.
You better preach that thing, Bishop.
Bishop, what you
talking
about?
You better preach
lukewarm.
That thing.
Lukewarm.
Yeah.
You can't sleep with a man all night Saturday
night.
Hey. And he ain't your husband and expect to have the Spirit on Sunday morning. Sunday after Sunday, you think you ain't fooling nobody, but let me tell you something. There's a thing that we call the prophetic anointing.
Talk about it.
Your neighbor say you're going to get showed up after a while.
Come on.
I see people, it ain't nobody here, it's not y'all. I'm just talking about y'all. I'm not talking about y'all. because y'all may not come back to the church no more, because I want you to come back. I need your help. I need your help. I need your help. So, it's funny how
you better preach
to church. You're so holy on Sunday morning, but when God calls you for ministry, you don't have enough for yourself. How you gonna help me?
You better preach.
See, let me tell you something. When you out of the spiritual alignment with
God,
if you are not covered by a spiritual leader, what you are is what you are. And excuse me if I offend you, but if you are out of alignment, out of cover with God, you are simply what we call a bastard.
You better talk.
Because if you don't know who your dad is, don't know who your spiritual leader is, you are out of order.
But he ain't told me nothing. Go ahead.
Yeah. It's time to get your house in order. And then they walk right out, get in their car, get on their cell phone. Let me sit next to you, baby. Yeah, I'm just going to bless you first for a second. Yeah. And they get on the phone.
Come on, Bishop.
And they call somebody else's husband. And say, I just told the pastor what the Spirit of the Lord told me.
Oh, my God.
Where we going to meet up tonight, baby? It ain't none of y'all in here, huh? It ain't none of y'all in here, huh? I have to say, somebody in this place, I have to say, but how in the hell you going to tell me about what the Spirit of the Lord told me? And you ain't number old scooped up tramp. How you going to tell me about the Spirit of God when